911, what's the nature of your emergency?
Every 3 minutes in the United States, someone visits an emergency room with a potentially life-threatening allergic reaction.
She was vomiting.
And his throat started to close.
Food allergies kill.
It was around this time that she was diagnosed with food allergies. She had to go to the emergency room for her first anaphylactic reaction. Ashley took her allergy with grace. She taught me how to be strong about it. Ashley was energetic, charismatic.
Hi.
She'd smile on a dime, just boom.
Ashley went into work that day. They were treating the staff to lunch. Ashley was on the phone with the person ordering, explaining that she had a food allergy. Ashley had called and wasn't feeling quite well, was perhaps having an allergic reaction. We made numerous calls back to the store and later learned that Ashley was in an anaphylactic state. They had called 911. By the time the ambulance got there, Ashley had already gone down. They revived her once.
There was so much confusion. I think they weren't prepared.
They brought her into the emergency room. The doctor told us that she only had a 3% chance of surviving. And she passed on December 1st, 2010, at 20 years of age. My heart broke. There was a physical feeling of a tear. That's a mother's pain.
There should have been somebody there to save my daughter.
I'm Lucas, take one.
What are you allergic to, Lucas?
Every nut except for a coconut.
My last reaction was when I was two.
He had one pistachio nut and his throat started to close within seconds before he could even have the second one. It was scary. It took us a while to wrap our heads around the fact that he couldn't have these things anymore. We're gonna do everything in our power to make him as safe as possible.
There's 8 foods that are the most common food allergens. Those include
peanuts, tree nuts,
milk,
egg,
wheat,
soy,
fish,
shellfish.
A food allergic reaction can cause hives, lip swelling, nausea, vomiting. They can have breathing issues and have blood pressure drop, and people unfortunately can die from a food reaction.
Year after year, the rate of food allergy is rising, and we have no definitive information as to why or how to stop it.
There are now 2 children in every class on the average that have food allergy. The biggest misconception people have about food allergies is that it's simply some type of annoyance, that it's not a real clinical illness.
It took my son's death for some of those people to realize that.
I think awareness is absolutely the first step. And I hear stories from patients that they went to their child's school and they tried to get certain accommodations and everyone was looking at them like, why are you here? This is not that big of a deal.
Some try and understand and some don't care to understand. That could be really frustrating and upsetting.
And until they understand that, it's very difficult to get folks to put together the kind of policies that we need in schools or in the community. They're gonna help keep our children safe.
Having a food allergy changes everything in your life.
We're always checking every ingredient in every food. We don't eat out at restaurants.
Allergies involve a family, a school, a community. It's too much of a burden and a responsibility for the child allergic to have to deal with that consequence on their own.
Once I felt scared because someone next to Sadie had nut terror. I was too scared to tell anybody.
The beauty of FAIR as a national organization is that we can create the national resources, the national programs, be the national voice in advocacy and policy, but the reason to be that is because we change lives at a very personal level.
FAIR is really there for you at every stage in your journey of food allergies. Our programs and our resources really kick in when you leave the allergist's office.
We really have an opportunity here with our clinical network, with our pharmaceutical partners, and with the groundswell of support we're seeing now to change the equation for people with food allergy.
An oral food challenge is a tool that we use in the clinic to help us determine in the beginning whether someone has a food allergy, if the diagnosis is unclear, or whether they might have had resolution of that food allergy over time.
Let's take a look at your belly. Can I see your belly?
It is really satisfying when we have a child who has been following us for years and has had multiple food challenges and comes for the last one and is cleared of all of their food allergies.
That's the result of today's test. We've discovered she's no longer allergic to sesame. That's exciting.
When somebody gets it right, it's kind of like a sigh of relief. It's like I can finally let my guard down for a moment. I could breathe.
You can do more than just survive. You can actually live.
It upsets him that he has an allergy, and I think being here and being part of the Fair Walk for Food Allergy is really great for him, and it's really encouraging for him to know that there are other kids just like him.
We're walking not just to remember people, but to hope for the future.
We walk together because we need each other.
My long-term goal is that food allergy becomes a controllable disease, that children aren't worried about dying from this. I swear I-